transit, Mars moves into Capricorn on 2nd of May 2018 and it stays there till 6th November 2018. In the meantime, it also goes retrograde, but that we transit we will cover in a different video. For now, the direct Mars conjunct Ketu in Capricorn for all the Lagnas. For Capricorn Lagna, it is a time for self-assertion and self-assessment. It is time to constantly develop your set skills so that in the coming time, you can have a lot of gains. It is also a good time to channelize your energy in a direction such that you learn how to control your anger and your emotions. It is a good time for your mother to stand tall and proud in her social circuit. And there is also some chances that she needs to take good care of her health. For the Aquarius Lagna, this is a time to develop your intuitive skills. You have been festering your energies in many different ways and places. It is time to gather those energies, mentally attune yourself in one direction and take up meditation and breathing exercises so that focus can be very straight. Intuitive skills, as in how the universe responds to you and to pick up the signals from the universe, is a good place to begin with because it is a time when these facilities can be developed within you very sharply, which will take you a long way in becoming the person that you want to and spiritually uplifting you. Pisces Lagna, it is the time to segregate your contacts which are useful for you and to pinpoint the kind of gains that you want. It is also the time when you can decide as to which traditional methods are very important and can be inculcated in your work, family and ethics to help you move ahead with a much greater insight and with much force. This in turn will help you make a better life for yourself and your family and also have you gain good in terms of money, prestige, honor, etc. Aries Lagna. For Aries Lagna, Mars and Ketu posited in the 10th house as the lord of 8th house combined means that it is time for you to put in all your energies, directed efforts towards your career. This would bring about a major transformation in your career, changing your lifestyle, and would also give you good gains. It is also the time when you need to put in your efforts in improving your own self also, because with the transformation of the self, a transformation in the career is bound to happen. Your working styles will undergo a change and your ability to foresee your research and your moving towards finding out more avenues in your career will bring about a change, a major one in your life for the coming months. For the Taurus Lagna, the 7th Lord goes into the 9th house, the 7th Lord of interaction with public and the 7th Lord of private life, of partnership, moving into the 9th house of tradition, truth, honesty. It is time that you expand in these areas of truth, honesty, standing up to your points, well, not very aggressively as is denoted by Mars and Ketu, but being very honest and candid about it, you will gain much benefit. Also, married life requires certain amount of transparency and lot of vigor. For that to succeed and for you to blossom in life, apply traditional methods of maintaining certain semblance in relationships and you will go a long way with an exalted Mars 7th Lord posited in your 9th house. For the Gemini Lagna, this is a great time of transformation. The 6th Lord of habits and services moves into the 8th house of transformations. With a lot of pressure, albeit you would be able to move and make things happen in your life. This pressure is good one for transforming your habits and letting go of those which are bad and taking up which are good. Service will also see a transformation. It is time you put in a lot of zealous effort because that will reap major benefits for you later on. It is also a time for you to make great inroads into your sadhana, into your practice, because that would also mean a lot in terms of getting you the knowledge that you so desire. Coming to Cancer Lagna, Cancer Nagra people, it is high time you put in all your efforts into your work, into your personal relationships. This, your yoga karaka moving into a position of exaltation with Ketu will give you great power, position in life, provided your direction and your attention is focused towards your career as well as towards your personal life. Yes, there is a time when you should be able to do both with a lot of aplomb. Mars, that is your yoga karaka, gives you enough energy to put in directed efforts at all ends. The power that you so aspired for, the position in your work that you were looking forward for, this is the right time for you to make a directional move, because you would be able to attain the heart's desire. Avoid acrimony in your personal life and it will take you places. For the Leo Lagna, a word of advice: stay calm, stay collected. Do not get into any acrimonious discussions, be it at home or your workplace. It is time that you concentrated in developing a set skill, enhance anything that is related to your profession, because that would be great for you in the coming time. It is also time that you put in some effort towards learning to sugarcoat what you have to say, because honest that you are, people may not be ready to hear the bare truth. It is also time for you to make inroads into your career, develop your own personality, and to do selfless service. This selfless service, this movement into your job, into your career, will help you in the times to come. For the Virgo Lagna, it is time now to unlock your destiny. Move towards giving a concentrated effort into your work. Try to take the blessings of your elders and bring about a change and a transformation in your life. It is time to let go of things that are not useful in your life. Ketu and Mars would help you cut away from such things. Also, it is a great period for you to undergo transformation and to also practice sadhana, because that will help you realize your potential. For the Virgo Lagna, it is a bit advised to be aware of your driving skills and also stay away from fire. For the Libra Lagna, it is the time to move in and take up an in-depth study of what is required to enhance your career. Laboriously trying to find out what is required, putting in your energy in that direction and collecting as much as information as possible towards your education will lead you to a lot of wealth accumulation and help you climb that rung of ladder into the corporate or personal world as can be. It is also the time when you put in some amount of energy towards your mother, towards your family, because they might also help you in enhancing your set skills so that you can move into a better place in public interaction. For the Scorpio Lagna, the search is over. It is time when you will be able to get a lot of your answers through proper channelizing of your energy through the subconscious mind. Try certain methods of breathing or meditation and sitting into a calm and quiet place when need for answers. Do not expect the answers at the same time. However, the answers will hit you at places unknown and at times most inappropriate, but they will be sure to express themselves very, very clearly. Be open and learn to accept and to understand the signals that the universe has for you, because it is bound to send you plenty of them. It is also the time not to get into any acrimony, not to get into any fights with siblings, with people in the family or with your friend circle, because ego, though may express itself in a big way, it's time to hold onto it in a very strong manner. It is also time to develop your spiritual practices so that you can move on to a higher plane, as you have always felt the need for. Now, finally, for the Sagittarius Lagna. For the Sagittarius Lagna, this is a great time to put in your effort into your work. It is time to take the help of elders to give you their blessings so that you can move into a new direction as far as your work is concerned. For the students, take time out, find research and go head on for your studies. For those who are traveling, you would come across different experiences which would take you to a different place altogether, move you into the higher spiritual quest that you were looking for. use of mantra shakti, or rather enhancing your powers and practicing the mantra shakti, would go a long way into taking you into a different religious and spiritual plane altogether. Praying to your ancestors is one way to make sure that you are capable and getting enough in terms of wealth, knowledge and education. So this is all about Mars moving into Capricorn and conjunct Ketu. However, we will deal in another video about the time when Mars turns retrograde and your energies in this field turn inward. Till then, have a nice time and keep a watch for this space. Thank you.